Welcome back. Well, the market's getting a bit iffy now. The Nifty is down 32. The bank Nifty is the one which is seeing a bit of a weakness now. 180 points down on that one. The mid-cap still doing well. Advanced decline at about 2:1. One of the stocks of the day is, of course, Triveni Turbine. Now, like we alerted you this morning, there's been a big block deal in Triveni Turbine with 21.8% equity changing hands. So to alert our viewers, earlier this year, the board of directors of Triveni Engineering had decided to divest their full 21.85% stake in the company. Nikhil Sawhney, a vice chairman and managing director at Triveni Turbines, is now joining us. Nikhil, good morning. So this is part of the plan, right? Who bought this stake?
Good morning. Yes, thank you for having us on. We're very proud that we have, and I believe, very marquee investors, many sovereign wealth funds and large international institutional investors, as well as very large mutual funds. And I think that we have, I believe, extremely quality investors. This was, of course, as you alluded to, a divestiture from the engineering side, where they sold 21.8%, I think, for approximately 1,600 crores. And we at Triveni Turbine are extremely proud of the fact that we've been able to actually expand the float of the stock, as well as the promoters itself have also bought 10% of that block.
Promoters bought 10%, and 11.85 is to the investors, which is...
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Because, you know, the reason I ask you is that between Sawhney family, and of course, Mr. Dhruv Sawhney holds about 7.2%, you yourself hold about 4.7%. So what will be the stake of the Sawhney family now? Will it be somewhere around 55% or thereabout?
Exactly. It is to an absolute majority, and that is the plan.
So
of course, they will be streamlining within the family so that they can be a clearer succession, but this is just...
So, sorry, I think your voice is breaking, Nikhil. I just wanted to understand... Okay, Nikhil, sorry, your voice is breaking. I think we need to get you back on a clearer line, because, you know, so just to put things in perspective, before this deal, promoters held about 67%, out of which, of course, the majority was with the Sawhney family, and Triveni Engineering, which is the sugar company of the group, that held about, 21% stake, out of which, 10% is being bought by the promoters of the company. And rest, as you said, has gone to some of the marquee investors. So, sorry, Nikhil, we got you back. Why not buy the entire stake? Are you comfortable letting this 10% go, 10 or 11% go?
Well, actually, the fact is that this was a sale from Triveni Engineering side. Of course, the liquidity had to be created by the promoters. As you could tell, this is quite a sizable deal. So the liquidity that we were able to create, I think, is ample for us to display utmost confidence in the company, which as you may know, is performing exceedingly well in the space that we're in. And so we're comfortable at this level, and we think that this is the long-term holding level of the promoters. As you would imagine, that while Triveni Engineering was deemed as a promoter, it never exercised any rights as a promoter. And so, very frankly, this is much clearer to have it in terms of holding structure.
Absolutely. So that point is clearer now. So, so Sawhney family now holds 55%, and there's no plan to sell any further. You'll stay at 55. That's part number one.
Exactly.
And if you could give us some details in terms of who bought. I mean, you said marquee investors, but a couple of names would help.
You know, I think that bankers will take the names out, but we had everyone from the sovereign wealth funds of Singapore and Abu Dhabi to large California-based mutual funds and, of course, very marquee Indian mutual funds, which you all know from the largest banks and largest mutual funds in the country. So we've had extremely good appetite. And as you would see, I think the bankers also did a very good deal with having the block sold at in the block window, which is at a minimal discount to previous close.
Nikhil, good morning. So how will the leadership structure now look at Triveni Turbine? What will be the core areas of focus for the turbine management?
Nothing changes. Well, very frankly, the business is doing exceedingly well. And thank you for asking that question. Triveni Turbine continues to be a leader in the space of small steam turbines and a global leader in the structurally buoyant area of thermal renewable solutions. As we see, over 50% of our demand comes from international market. And structurally, despite the uncertainty that exists with fixed capital formation internationally, the renewable energy investments are something that are quite consistent. In fact, the insecurity driven around energy prices has has actually propelled this market even further. Despite that, we believe that our expansion of the market, addressable market, by looking at it from a perspective of larger steam turbines, has also given confidence in our order booking. Ultimately, in our last investor call, we'd given a visibility of growth of the business of 35% CAGR for this year as well as next year. And this is a visibility that we get not only out of our order book, which grew by over 100% last year, but also of our inquiry book, which suggests a very, very good order booking in the coming quarters and then therefore for this year, which will, of course, get executed in the next financial year. But from a strategy management perspective, nothing is changing.
Okay, but since the business is doing quite well, do you plan to reward shareholders of Triveni Engineering post this block deal and raising funds? Is a buyback on the cards anytime soon?
You know, well, I can speak only for Triveni Turbines. I would imagine that those are decisions that would have to be taken by the board of directors of Triveni Engineering. And I'm sure that they would look at things in a prudent manner, depending on whatever their capex plans may be.
Nikhil, hi.
Unfortunately, I can't speak any thoughts.
Nikhil, hi. Good morning. Prashant here. Could you tell us what is the value of orders you've taken in Q2 so far? I mean, the order book stood at about 3,600 crores at the end of Q1.
No, I think the value may be slightly different from what you're saying. But as we sit in the middle of Q2 and toward the end of Q2, our order booking has been consistent in its growth that we saw even in Q1. In fact, our growth is in far excess of that. We are in a manner to... since we don't report individual orders at this point in time, and we've reported only at the quarterly end date, suffice to say that the growth in the order booking has sustained.
Sorry, you said the number was different. I have a number at 3580 crores to be precise. Are you saying it was higher? Higher?
3580 was from last quarter. No, that was an absolute order booking.
Yes.
The order backlog was in excess of 1200 crores.
Yeah.
As you understand, our order execution cycle is about 9 months.
Right.
And so that figure is suggestive of a 9-month turnover.
Mm.
We believe in this current quarter we've had some very good wins.
Right.
This has been backed not only in the domestic market by some large orders that have come in through the CPSE route. There is a lot of capex that is happening throughout the okay. ecosystem. As a steam turbine provider into the commoditized space, we are a beneficiary of fixed capital formation in the space. And so we, right now, investments in oil and gas, cement, fertilizer, chemicals, petrochemicals is something that we are benefiting from, apart from the traditional markets of cement, waste heat recovery, or sugar distilleries, etc.
Okay. No, Nikhil, sorry, I just wanted to understand the basic structure once again, because even if you go to the Triveni Engineering shareholders, there also, I think, you have shareholding, I think... Tarun has shareholding. I think, of course, your father, Mr. Dhruv Sahni, also has, like in Triveni Turbine, stake here. So what's the eventual plan, in terms of the overall structure going forward for both these names? Because you all three have stakes in both the companies.
Yes, as you could see, I think the ultimate plan, as I am the Vice Chairman and Managing Director of Triveni Turbine and my brother is the Vice Chairman and Managing Director of Triveni Engineering,
yeah.
It would be for majority shareholding to reside with the operational executives of that business from a family perspective. As you rightly pointed out, the principal promoters are my father, my mm-hmm. brother and myself. Mm-hmm. And as my father's plans his succession, it will logically fall to the sibling that is operationally in charge of that business.
Okay, so there will be more inter-se promoter transfers going forward between the brothers?
Yes, I think that is safe to assume.
Okay.
I would imagine that the resultant would be that the operational executive would have in excess of 50% and that the resultant individual shareholding would continue. Mm-hmm. So that there is some degree of participation within the family from a long-term perspective.
So from the patriarch point of view, Mr. Sawhney will, Dhruv Sahni will continue to hold his stake. The brothers, over the next few years, will completely take over the two companies and have the interstate transfer, is it?
Yes. I would imagine that my father would actually gift it on to the correct sibling.
Okay. So both siblings then eventually will have the 55% stake in respective companies. That's the eventual plan.
No, I think Triveni Engineering, just as a resultant shareholding stake, may be higher than that.
Okay.
So, but I think you're going into matters which I think are a little fluid, but the incentive and the direction are clear.
No, but the succession planning is very clear. It will happen in this way.
Yes, that is very clear. Okay. In terms, I think both businesses are in a very good spot right now. Mm. I think, as you pointed out, there is a very strong government policy which is driving the sugar sector, as well as the capex that is happening in areas like defense, which is benefiting Triveni Engineering. Triveni Turbine has a more global approach, and our investments into research and development, which are really the forefront of what capital goods companies in India are doing, has really borne fruit for us to attain a global leadership position. And we're very excited about some of the developments that are coming out and which we'll be reporting in the next several quarters, which will further expand our reach and value proposition into the market.
Talking about the business then, there's an expansion of the Sompura facility that was to take place was to be completed by Q2 of this year. How much is the incremental revenues that one can expect from it?
Well, if you look at our balance sheet, we have a high asset turnover. So very frankly, we're not... And what I mean by that is that this expansion, which took place in capacity for testing, assembly, and quality control, was at the extent of about 35 odd crores, which expanded our capacity by approximately 30%. So that sounds like a very small number for such a large capacity increase. But if you look at it from the perspective of capacity constraints of the company, we don't face any. We may be expanding capacity further, given the unprecedented demand that we're seeing in certain sectors. So there may be further expansion that we may see in Sompura in the coming year, which, of course, we will take through the board. The utilization of this capacity, we imagine, would be near full by the end of next year, next calendar year.
Okay.
Got that, Nikhil. Just one thing, your margins, EBITDA margins at the end of the last quarter were just under 19%. And you kind of guided that they could be upwards of 20%. Are you on track for that this quarter, this year, for the year?
Yes. Actually, what we find in this year is we are a beneficiary of the orders that we took in the previous year. And in the previous year, we took in more orders from the domestic market, which have always carried lower margins for us. As we get into the execution of this financial year, not only do we have more exports, but we have operating leverage in terms of an expansion in our overall turnover. That coupled with a reduction in base raw material prices, as you may have noticed, steel prices, copper, etc., have come down. But it takes a little bit of time for it to translate down into a bottom line. Sure. Should mean that we don't have margin pressure. But at the same time, we will be spending more money on employees. We expanded our workforce by about 10% last year. Again, we'll be expanding our workforce by between 15 to 18% this year. This is all to cater to the over 35-40% growth that we will see in the current next year and going forward as well.
Okay. Nikhil, we appreciate your thoughts. Thanks a lot for fielding all of our questions and giving us a lot of information on the company. So that's Triveni Turbine.